tensions increased and offered a possibility for the study of new weapons. The United States Navy had already experimented with a nuclear submarine, the Nautilus, and with its experience in rocket research, came up with a new weapon, the Polaris missile. Utilization of this new rocket required considerable time and research. The project called for the launching of a rocket with an atomic warhead from an underwater submarine. The rocket would be capable of reaching almost any target on Earth. Before the United States could put these new weapons into operation, there were many problems to be solved. One was the placement of the rockets in the submarines. Another was the problem of launching. This was particularly difficult because of the necessity of launching underwater, which affects the deflection angle. Tests were done above water, and subsequent tests were done from a stationary pad underwater. Subsequently, in all space research, man soon found other benefits from space research. Pioneer 5, launched by the United States on March 11, 1960, transmitted to Earth new magnetic data about the Earth's surface and the solar system. Taros began the era of the meteorological weather satellites launched by the United States. Taros 1, launched into space April 1st, 1960, weighed 268 pounds and contained television equipment. It transmitted pictures of everything it encountered. The Taros satellites were also equipped with photographic devices and were able to register Earth's thermal zones. One of the first of these satellites transmitted to Earth 22,952 photographs. From the study of these pictures, we were able to analyze the various movements of clouds and foresee with accuracy the time and location of storms and atmospheric disturbances. There are many satellites in space, providing a continuous flow of information to receiving Earth stations and mankind benefits. For example, Taros 3 was able to accurately predict 7 storms that hit the Florida coast, and consequently, many lives were saved and millions of dollars in property damage was averted. Still one of the most important aspects aspects of space research is the study of the behavior of living things in space. On August 19th, 1960, the Russians launched a capsule containing two dogs, Belka and Strelka, which was successfully recovered. Satellite communications continued to improve. On August 12, 1960, 15 minutes after launching from Cape Canaveral, Echo 1, a 100-foot balloon, was separated from the third stage rocket at a predetermined height and inflated to its full size. Communication between people from all corners of the earth.